Hi there and welcome back to UFO Karakoyimlu, the Black Sheep. And we are currently expanding internally. Our new Sultan has glorious administrative abilities and he wants to use them to build worldly things, which is why he's being regarded as a sinner. He sees the church as a pragmatic tool to further the power of the state. And that is not going well with the Ulema. Now, what he wants to do is give us a sustainable treasury. And to do that, he'll use his great administrative skill and, as soon as it is possible, focus on administrative power. Because he sees that we are back in administrative technology as well, and he wants to claw back there, as well as maybe in military technology. So, we've just won a war against Khorasan, and why I'm looking at the culture is someone wanted to see the culture of our realm, and it's mainly Azerbaijani, Kurdish, Persian and Luri. We can also look at... where could we see that? Come on. There we are. Azerbaijani, Mashriki, Kurdish. These are the accepted ones. Then we have Persian, Luri, Georgian and Mazandrani. Also we want to look if gaining provinces leading to Persia can be there. So these are the goals of Pirbudak the first. And his heir, probably his brother or cousin, the martial educator, probably influencing his decisions in wars with his military skill. Recall our Ardabili. And we have looked at the rivals, and so we'll obviously not take our allies as rivals. We'll repeat Khorasan as rival. We'll see how long that can be done, though, but yeah, that's the way we want to do it. And now... we've set ourselves a limit of 460. Every time we reach 460, we may build a building. And we prefer to build workshops, as we have to be declared a sinner. So a mosque is so-so. Have to look at... we could correct the inflation, but we could also not. We'll also wait a bit. Let's go for the workshop. So Tehran has a good workshop that we could build. There we go. And now, as it's peace times ahead, we can also mothball all the forts. Just have to have a watchful eye on the rebels' factions. Khorasan still wants to claim things here. And that's not possible. Come on. With that. Ottoman opinion. Improved relations 50. We can do better. We can do a royal marriage with them. And we have a new sultana. An Ottoman sultana. Huma. Look at that. What a glorious sultana we have. What a glorious wife we have. Huma Osmanoglu. Oh. Wow. A true prodigy. Good in administration. Very good in diplomatic skill and extremely good in military skill. She's beating her husband and his brother in chess. And that says something, because they're not bad at chess. He's more the positional player, going for long time advantages, and he is one with a wild maneuvers. sacrifices, and she's fertile. So if Pirbudak Karakoyundu is disinherited or dies, there will be a new heir quickly. There will be a new heir quickly. And now, let's send someone here, actually, to further our ambition with the Ottomans. Improve relations. Royal marriage offer from Mazandaran as well. Yes, of course. Why not? It's one of our allies. We just fought a war with them. Together with them, and everything should be fine. Look at that, Khorasan is totally occupied. Still at war with Afghanistan, Jaunpur, and Ladakh. Jaunpur we have seen moving around with a 31k stack, so they are serious business. Good relations, a good vassal, not a good vassal, a good rival. Everything goes well. Personality human. And we would love to raise and plunder? Maybe we would. And invest in a new idea. Can we? Yeah, I think we can. Noble officers. It makes sense to give the aristocrats something to play with. Noble officers. Our army will be great. Yearly army tradition decay and navy tradition decay goes down. Who leads our troops? Who leads our troops is an important choice. Our nobility is seeking to ensure that preference is given to them. It will give them a chance to show their valor by giving the enemy cold steel, and we will allow them to do this. And we also have dynamic warfare now. Our region has proven perilous for many invaders. The mountains, deserts, plains, and forests of the Caucasus and Iran require quick adaptation to local circumstances and a keen eye for strategic and tactical advantages. Our prolonged warfare against other Turkoman federations and the Timurids have allowed us to perfect a dynamic form of warfare, mixing raids, grand maneuver warfare, and pitched battles. We gain land leader maneuver plus one, which is really good in this region for the reasons mentioned. A lot of territory with high attrition, also in winter. Afghanistan doesn't want any access anymore, which means the war may end here. We'll see about that. They are also at war with... They are at war with Chagatai and Kazan and losing there. God. And here. Astrakhani separatists from Russia invading the Ottoman steppes. Everything is going a little strange now. Who's that? Brunswick! Brunswick is in the Ottoman territory, really. Look at that. They're at war with something similar to the Holy Roman Empire. They are probably target of a crusade. Or something like that. How crazy is that? And what is happening to Afghanistan? Is Afghanistan in another war? No. Are they advancing someday? Sometime? We don't know. There's nothing happening here, which is really strange. Our treasury is rising. Soon we may build another workshop. In Basra, why not? Basra is a good place. Military access from Kazan. Das Kazan want. They have a war against Transoxiana. Transoxiana is a country that has been our rival. And yeah, but we don't want them to be taken apart by Kazan. That's... No, Kazan doesn't really like us. We don't really like them. They have a different religion. They cannot do anything to us, so... Why would we want to do this? Look at that, Khorasan is recovering, famously. And there's Jaunpur, with a very small army compared. They are moving back. Is this the turning point? And we have merchants worried about lack of protection. Our focus on free trade, our merchants are concerned that they are not getting the support they would get under a more mercantilist policy. Now I think he would be the mercantilist. He would concentrate on the own country rather than, yeah, building up the own country rather than going necessarily to other nations with a diplomatic skill of 3. He wants to concentrate on building up. That's his vision. His vision is a Karakol Yunlu of workshops. And, well, maybe there's something we can do. We will protect our traders in the inland, so they can use the workshops very fit. Very good. Look at that, Khorasan is, wow, back on track. But Jaunpur is also there, and Afghanistan. And everything is happening at once. Holy Roman Empire? What? Oldenburg is leading the... What? And the Evangelical Union is victorious. Protestantism is now the dominant faith in the empire. Really? Let's have a look before we have the treason against this. Protestantism. We have a Protestant Holy Roman Empire. You don't see that often. Now we have treason. Recruitment is out of necessity something that has to be somewhat decentralized affair. Often it will be entrusted to nobles in the capital. Yeah, the nobles. And then they are responsible to turn up a set number of men in the various provinces under our control. This is a system that to some extent relies on trust, as the central government is not involved in the details of countryside mustering. And the only form of control we have are the often sporadic inspections the army itself conducts. One such inspection in Arbil has unearthed quite a local scandal. Arbil, that's in the middle somewhere. Here. That's Arbil. A local scandal. Now the highlands of Arbil. Let's have a look. How does this look? Yeah, there in the trees and the highlands where they think no one is noticing. The roads we have for the area is full of fictional names and nobody seems to know what we could actually muster from the region. What? Yeah, I mean, reassessment survey or corrupted army roles? Will he be the one to accept such a... No, he's probably someone who wants everything professional, right? With a high administrative skill. He wants administration, and this is clearly administration, to work flawlessly. We must punish the perpetrator and conduct our own survey. Surveys are serious business. Could go for state firearm regiments. Now that was dubbed much too costly by a predecessor. And he is also one to be likely. Lithuania, really? Where's Lithuania? Here. Far away. Also be likely. And I've lost the thread here. A Anyways, we have good income and we'll build more workshops for now. We can finally get administrative technology, and a courthouse is also something he will support as a counter measure to the mosques, right? A number of states goes up. That's all very good. There we go. The problem with hereditary local nobility is that they tend to value their local interests over those of the rest of the nation. We need to steadily expand the reach of the government, which begins with the most important area of administration, justice. We can now build courthouses, and we can make states. Look at that. Yeah, three states are... Yeah, we have complete states here. Kartli. Kaketi. We need some administrative power before, so we'll wait for that. We'll wait for that. Where's that? A courthouse. A courthouse will be also pretty fine. Ajam is back. Really? What is Ajam now? Most importantly, Ajam has Isfahan and Yazd. Oh. And we have a show superiority against them. Are they at war with someone? What is going on with them? We have to find this out. This could be a golden opportunity. While we are shying away from war, we are not shying away from war that is very easy to win. That would be something that his Sultana and his Shahzade would abhor. So that is something he should really think about, our Sultan. Ajam, our long-time traditional enemy, is back in existence, and he has no allies. Got a small army of 6,000 people. And maybe this is the time. Transoxiana, can you return home? Also... We might just prepare for that, because they have no allies. Let's man the forts. Let's move the armies into position. 19, 24, 16, we don't care, let's move in. This is a golden opportunity. A golden opportunity for war. Look at that. Persia lies at the old dream of our father lies at our feet defenselessly. And Khorasan is no longer a valid rival. Whom can we take? Lithuania? Would be useless. Mazandran and Shirvan are our allies. Let's take Akkoyunlu again. And now? Could we declare war? Showing superiority. Our allies would join us, but it wouldn't be necessary at all for our allies to join us. This is a golden opportunity indeed. Will we take this? We will probably take this. Thank you for watching, and happy gaming to you. We'll meet in the next episode when the black sheep may decide to ram again. Have a good time until then and happy gaming.